Hello guys, today's video is going to teach you how to using this item right here, 15495, the high grade carbon reinforced plate set to making the underguard setup like this one right here. Okay, and for the detail of how this thing function and how this thing works, we're going to talk about it by the end of this video. Okay, so first let's talk about what the type of tool we need for finishing this job right here. So first we need a screwdriver, nut driver, and a Tamiya like the gauge. And the files, and of course you need a Dremel right here. So different type of cutting bit. This is a disc cutting bit, and also need a 2-3 millimeter different grinder. So this is the cylinder one, which is long and round, and this is the another one. It is which is a little bit like a round on the head, like this one right here. Let me give you a better angle. You can see. Okay, and also we need this one right here. This is for polishing. Okay. And for the screw, you need a 2 5-millimeter screw, which is right here. Okay, and a 2 regular nut and 2 large Tamiya washer. Okay, like this one right here. I'm pretty sure a lot of people see this one in the other package. Okay, the next we need it is the Y marker. Okay, and a hand drill, 2 millimeter hand drill, which is right here. And also you need a digital caliper. Let's move into the next, and I'm gonna start and teach you how to make it. Okay, we're gonna starting from this carbon fiber pieces first. This thing, it is about 91 millimeter long and 7.15 millimeter for the width. Okay, so first we're gonna divide this one to half. It is about 3.56, around like that. So we're gonna using a knife as a marker, okay, to follow the line right here. So you can see, let me give a better angle, so you can see there's a different mounting point which is located on the top of the carbon fiber. So what are we gonna do? It is we're gonna try to using your eye level to get a half of that to make a mark right here. Okay, same thing right here. Just using your eye level to take a look at it, to make sure you can break this thing to be a half. Okay, so this is half mark right here, and there's another half mark right here. Okay, so next what we're gonna do it is we're gonna using the digital caliper to take a look at it. So make sure it is 3.56 about right there. So it's about right here, see that? So just make sure the mark you just make on the top, on the surface of the carbon fiber, it is about 3.55 or either 3. So I would say you can try to make it between 3.55 to 3.58. It doesn't really matter, just make sure it's getting closer possible. So next we're gonna using this Tamiya gauge right here to follow the mark to connect the line, which is can break this thing to be a half. Okay, let me give a better angle. So as you can see right here, I already have a line right here. So this is break my whole carbon fiber popsicle to be a half. Okay, so next we're gonna using this item right here, the item number 15430, the FRP rear multi-roller sitting state. So we're gonna using 2 5-millimeter screw and set up the screw right here. And the other one right here. Then next, gonna play this one right match to the right mounting point, which is right here. Okay, so next, we're gonna using the nut to lock it. Next, be really careful, and you have to make sure this thing is not crooked. So just make sure you can make it on the right place. Okay, so you can see this right here a little bit log off, here a little bit off as well. So just gonna be slowly adjust it, make sure everything lines up. See that? See this little mounting point right here, and this mounting point right here, including here, here. Make sure everything lines up. Okay. So next, we're gonna do the same thing. From here, we're gonna break half, okay, like this. Same thing here, gonna break half. Let me give you a better angle. You can see the line right here. So this is the line right here. So next, we're just going to using the Tamiya gauge, and they have a little bit like edges right here we can use for that. And gonna go ahead, set up right here, and follow the line. Do the mark again, okay, like this. See this line right here, here to here. Okay, same thing right here. We're gonna do the same thing. So right now you can see one intersection point, which is right here. You can see, and the same thing as here, you can see another intersection point, which is located right here. Okay, next you're gonna using a digital caliper, which is right here. You have to make sure the intersection from here to here have to be 32 millimeter. Okay, so gonna go ahead using a digital caliper to see. See, just make sure everything is accurate. So this is about 32 millimeter. Actually, a little bit off is okay, but make sure it's make it as close as possible. So as you can see right now, the intersection just marked right here. Let me give a better angle right here. From this point to this point, it is 32 millimeter. Okay, because the reason I'm gonna make it 32 millimeter because these two mounting point right here. The from the center to this center, actually it is about 32 millimeter. Okay, so that's why you have to make two mark right here, so we can using the 2 millimeter drill to make two new mounting point right here, which will to fit right here for later we can mounting these little pieces on the bottom of the chassis, which will locate two mounting point right here. Okay, so moving to the next, we're just gonna go ahead using a hand drill to make the hole. Okay, just make sure you have to be really center, okay, and slowly. So okay, you can see here the two new mounting points I just make. Again, it doesn't really matter how you make these two holes. You can use a hand drill or any kind of electrical drill, doesn't really matter as long as you can make these two little holes right here. So you can do your own way, don't really have to follow me. Okay, so let's move into the next. We're gonna try to shave these two little pieces like this type, because if you try to put the whole piece right here, it's gonna block the wheel. Okay, so the wheel cannot move. So that's why we have to remove all these little pieces right here into open place right here. So in this case, the wheel can move a little bit freely. Okay. So for the next, what you have to do it is you're gonna using a marker, which is right here, to mark the part you're gonna cut off. But before we doing that, we're gonna using that two little screw right here. Okay, I'm gonna set right here. And set up right here. Okay, just make sure set up the two new mounting point which look we just make. Okay, and then next gonna put two large washer which right here and another one right here. Okay, then we're gonna using the nut. Okay, to lock it. Like this. Okay, before you lock all the way, make sure the washer is in the center of the screw. So which means, as you can see, here's a little bit more, here a little bit less. So what you're gonna do it is you're gonna push a little bit, make it's very even in the center. So each side can be very evenly like this. Okay, so you can see the bottom still have a little bit more. So I'm gonna push up a little bit and slowly using your nail to adjust it. And the next, when you finish adjusting, just lock all the way. Okay, like this. Still not even, but try to get as close as possible. Okay, same thing as this one right here. So we're gonna adjust it and make sure it's in the center. Then we lock all the way. Okay, so for this part, I'm gonna explain later when after finish cutting it. Okay, so next we're gonna using a marker to mark the part we're gonna cut off. So the part basically we're gonna cut off, it is from here. Okay, like this. In the middle, we're gonna do the same thing. And this side, same thing right here. Okay, so here the first reason I put two washer right here. So the washer is telling me I have to stop right here. So when you're cutting it, then you know where you should stop. Okay, so you're gonna stop right here, about right here, the edges of washer right here, and the same thing right here, you're gonna stop right here, and the same thing right here, same thing right here. That's the point of stop. That's why I put two washer to make sure I know where to stop. And for the second reason for the washer setup here, I'm gonna talk about after finishing cutting it. That's it. There's another function about these two washer over there. Okay. So for cutting this, we're gonna using the Dremel cutter, which is this one right here. Okay. So make sure you wear the safety equipment, which is goggle and mask, because when you're cutting it, there's a lot of carbon fiber products coming out, and you don't really want to breathe on it. So it's better to having a mask and the goggle. Okay, and if you have a vacuum, which is like the one I have right here, and you can turn on the vacuum and during the same time cutting, it can just like suck all the remaining sand into the vacuum. And in this case, you don't need any mask to protect your breath. Okay, so next, I'm just gonna go ahead and cut it. For cutting it, it's very simple. Just make sure you're using a Dremel, which is right here. Okay. And set up the RPM. It really depends your scale. So like this one, this is RPM from 5,000 to 20,000 Dremel. So you can adjust between 5,000 to 20,000. I always using about 10,000 RPM to cutting the carbon fiber. But it really depends on how many torque you have on your Dremel. So if you feel it's hard to cutting it, try to raise a little bit higher RPM in order to making it cutting a little bit soft. Okay, so let me just go ahead and cutting it. So right here, just finish first step to cutting it. So you can see right here being separate. So next, we're gonna using Dremel to cut it from this way to remove these all the Y pieces right here. Okay. So you can see, so it's almost there. So you can see the shape already. So moving to the next, we're gonna using a different cutting bit, which is this one right here, the polished one, okay? So we're gonna using this polished one to round up the shape. Okay, so remember, I talked about we keep two large wash right here. So this is second function. So we're gonna using this polishing bit to follow the wash the round shape to make the round design. So right now you can see from back it is square. Okay, so you have to make it a little bit round. Okay, so in order to fit all type of design, such as right here. Okay, so you have to make it round in order to fit right here, because this is another type of setting which we're using the 3-point attachment. So in this case, you have to have a little bit round design right here in order to fit to the little notch right here. Okay, So next, we're just gonna go ahead and show you how to make it like a run like that. So okay, we just finished here, so you can see right now I have a little bit wrong design, okay, like this. The next, we're gonna remove these two screws and a washer. Okay, so right here it's about 80% finished right here. Next, we're gonna using a files to fix the scrap, because after you trim off, for sure there's a lot of scrap over there, so you're gonna using a files to adjust it. Okay, same right here, we're gonna adjust it, makes nice finishing. Okay, so let me give you a better angle. Okay, so next we're gonna teach you how to set up this one right here. Okay, right now we're gonna teach you how to set up this one right here. Before I start the setup, it's really hard for me to cover everything today for setting up this one, because everybody have different type. Because everybody had different size of the wheel and everybody had different design of tail, so it's really hard for me to cover everything for detailed setup on different situation. So I'm just gonna give you some, you know, in general idea how this thing should be set up looks like. Okay, so I'm using 25 millimeter wheel on Super 2 chassis, which is kind of small for Super 2 chassis, but it's okay. Okay, and first thing, this is the roller stay, which is you should have. Okay, so this is going on the top right here, and this one, make sure it's going always going to the lowest sitting on the bottom of the chassis. Okay, so it's gonna be looks like this. Okay, so you have to make sure this thing have to be about 1.5. I will say in general this thing have to be about 1.5 millimeter to 2 millimeter away from the ground. Okay, so I gonna using, so if you're too high or too low, you have to using an aluminum spacer or washer to adjust the you know, the gap. So for my sitting right here, it's already perfect. I don't need to put any spacer or washer to adjust the height of the sitting right here. So what I'm gonna do, I'm just gonna put on right here right now and moving to the next step. Okay, so I'm gonna using 2 15 millimeter screw right here. Okay, to position my underguard. Okay, it's gonna be looks like this. Next, gonna put on the setting bar and make sure this thing, it is about 1 millimeter at least away from the ground. So like I want to say, the best setting, it is 1.5 to 2 millimeter. So my pieces right here about 1.8 millimeter away from the ground right here, and the same thing right here. Okay, 1.8 millimeter, as you can see. Okay, but next we're gonna have another problem. Due to we didn't modify the little mounting point right here, okay, so my screw, it is less than 1 millimeter. Okay, so almost hitting the ground. Okay, see that? So these two schools become illegal. Okay, so right now you have two options. So I'm gonna teach you how to get rid of these two school head for the next setup. Okay, so first we're gonna remove the school first. Okay, so in order to make it legal, we have tried to hiding the school head into the carbon fiber. So you have two options. So first option, it is if you have the EVO flathead screw, which is come from the EVO car kit. Let me give you some sample how it looks like. It is looks like this. Okay, so this is a flathead screw, which is most people commonly use for setting up the screw head, which is hiding into the carbon fiber. So you have to using the wrong 3mm grinder. Okay, so what are we gonna do next? It is we're gonna using the Dremel and set up the wrong head grinder on it, and turn the Dremel to the low speed, which is 5000. Okay, and then next we're gonna place this one on the table. Okay, we're gonna drill a kind of like a probably halfway deep the hole, make it a little bit deeper. Okay, let me focus a little bit, can see the detail. So it's gonna be looks like this. So in this case, the flathead screw can hide into the carbon fiber. So this is not deep enough. So as you can see, we still have a little bit stick out. Okay, in this case, we have to make it a little bit deeper in order to this head can hide into the carbon fiber all the way. Okay. Okay, so still too small, so we're just gonna keep going. Okay, so it's about like this. So right now you can see the screw head can hide into the carbon fiber. Let me make it a little bit bigger. And it looks like this. Okay, so next let's try to put this one back to the chassis. Okay, so it's gonna be looks like this. Okay, right now let me give you a better angle. You can see the screw head, basically it's already deep into the carbon fiber right here. So with this type of setting, it's no longer nothing stick out, everything is clear. Okay, see that? So everything is about 1.8 millimeter away from the ground. Okay, so you may ask me if the cases you don't have this type of screw, what you gonna do? Okay, so this is the second option you have. You still can using the wrong screw, which is right here, the Tamiya standard screw. Okay, but the different setup you're gonna do, it is you're gonna make a little bit special on the hole we just made. So first, you're still gonna use this one right here to make the open place like the so you're still gonna using the wrong the bit first to making the deep design like this. But the next, you're gonna change to the cylinder style, which is this one right here. Okay. And then what you're gonna do, it is you're gonna make it a little bit like deeper, okay? Because this one inside is like a like this type of like offset design. So because the flathead screw, it is like, let me give a better angle. You can see the flathead screw, the design, see that? It's like a jar, okay? Like this, okay? That's why you have to use the wrong one, and then you can make it the this part of the point like this. So in this case, this one can fit into it. And but look at the regular screw, it is like a, it's like very evenly like right here, it's completely flat. That's why you have to using this wrong one right here. That's why you have to using this wrong one right here to make it to fit this type of screw head. Okay, what you're gonna do, it is you're gonna using the Dremel. A better angle, you can see. Just make sure slowly, because you don't wanna break it. Because make sure it don't go all the way, otherwise this gonna be damaged. Okay, so you're gonna make the little bit design like this. Let me give you a better angle, you can see. Okay, so in this case, this screw can almost hide into it. Let me give a better angle, you can see. See like this. Okay, so you can keep going slowly until it is about 95% into the carbon fiber. Just make sure do it little by little. Okay, like this. So right now it's almost there, so you should stop, because there's no way you can hide the Tamiya screw like this one right here to 100% hiding to the carbon fiber. There's no way. But I'm gonna give you another trick, which is can hide into it like 100%. Okay, so what you're gonna do next, it is you're gonna put on the chassis first. And set it up, and set up. Okay, so you can see this still a little bit stick out, but it's okay. You can using the polish head, which is this one right here, remember? And using this one, to shave off a little bit of screw head, Okay, what I mean it is, you're gonna take the regular screw. Okay, and using this polish head. To shave off a little bit. So it's gonna be looks like this. Let me give a better angle. You can see. Okay. Then let me put it back. You can see the result. Okay, so you can see it's already, compared with this one, I still have a little bit stick out right here. This one already gone. Okay, so when you put on a sitting bar, so next when you put on sitting bar, check again. You won't see anything stick out. Okay, like this. Okay, so it's gonna be looks like this. So again, everybody had different type of design, especially the wheel size. Okay, so you can using a aluminum spacer or either washer to adjust the height of the these little pieces right here. Okay, so make sure it's not blocking the roller, not blocking the wheel. This one have to be always the lowest point of the chassis. And it's highly recommend this piece is about 1.5 millimeter to 2 millimeter away from the ground. So again, this one right here, it is about 1.8, which right here you can see it's about 1.8 millimeter away from the ground, which is pretty good. Okay, so if you want to go lower, go ahead and go lower, but make sure you have 1 millimeter clearance, the regulation. So make sure this piece is not going too low, like lower than 1 millimeter. So just keep it safe, like between 1.5 to 2 millimeter. Okay, so next I'm gonna show you a video clip, like a to explain how this thing, why it's very important. Okay, right now I'm gonna teach you how to set up this one right here. Before I start the setup, it's really hard for me to cover everything today for setting up this one, because everybody had different size of the wheel and everybody had different design of tail. So it's really hard for me to cover everything for detailed setup on different situation. So I just gonna give you some, you know, in general idea how this thing should be set up looks like. Okay, so I'm using 25 millimeter wheel on Super 2 chassis, which is kind of small for Super 2 chassis, but it's okay. Okay, and first thing, this is the roller stay, which is you should have. Okay, so this is going on the top right here, and this one make sure it's going always going to the lowest sitting on the bottom of the chassis. Okay, so it's gonna be looks like this. Okay, so you have to make sure this thing have to be about 1.5, I will say in general this thing have to be about 1.5 millimeter to 2 millimeter away from the ground. So if you're too high or too low, you have to using an aluminum spacer or washer to adjust the you know, the gap. So for my sitting right here, it's already perfect. I don't need to put any spacer or washer to adjust the height of the sitting right here. So what I'm gonna do, I'm just gonna put on right here right now, and I'm moving to the next step. Okay, so I'm gonna using 2 15 millimeter screw right here to position my underguard. Okay, it's gonna be looks like this. Next, I'm gonna put on a sitting bar and make sure this thing, it is about 1 millimeter at least away from the ground. So like I want to say, the best setting it is 1.5 to 2 millimeter. So my pieces right here about 1.8 millimeter away from the ground right here, and the same thing right here. Okay, 1.8 millimeter as you can see. Okay, but next we're gonna have another problem. Due to we didn't modify the little mounting point right here. Okay, so my screw, it is less than 1 millimeter. Okay, so almost hitting the ground. Okay, see that? So these two screws become illegal. Okay, so right now you have two options. So I'm gonna teach you how to get rid of these two screw head for the next setup. Okay, so first we're gonna remove the screw first. Okay, so in order to make it legal, we have tried to hiding the screw head into the carbon fiber. So you have two options. So first option, it is if you have the Evo flathead screw, which is come from the Evo car kit. Let me give you some sample how it looks like. It is looks like this. Okay, so this is a flathead screw, which is most people commonly use for setting up the screw head, which is hiding into the carbon fiber. So you have to using the wrong 3 millimeter grinder. Okay, so what are we gonna do next? It is we're gonna using the Dremel and set up the wrong head grinder on it, and turn the Dremel to the low speed, which is 5,000. Okay, and then next we're gonna place this one on the table. We're gonna drill a kind of like probably halfway deep the hole, make it a little bit deeper. Okay, let me focus a little bit, you can see the detail. Okay, let me get a better angle, you can see. So it's gonna be looks like this. So in this case, the flathead screw can hide into the carbon fiber. So this is not deep enough. So as you can see, we still have a little bit stick out. Okay, in this case, we have to make it a little bit deeper in order to this head can hide into the carbon fiber all the way. Okay. And it looks like this. Okay, so next let's try to put this one back to the chassis. So, okay, right now let me give it a better angle. You can see the screw head, basically it's already deep into the carbon fiber right here. So with this type of setting, it's no longer nothing stick out, everything is clear. Okay, see that? So everything is about 1.8 millimeter away from the ground. Okay, so you may ask me if the cases you don't have this type of screw, what are you gonna do? Okay, so this is a second option you have. You still can using the wrong screw, which is right here, the Tamiya standard screw. Okay, but the different setup you're gonna do, it is you're gonna make a little bit special on the hole we just made. Okay, so you're still gonna using the wrong the bit first to making the deep design like this, but the next you're gonna change to the cylinder style, which is this one right here. Okay, and then what you're gonna do, it is you're gonna make it a little bit like deeper. Okay, because this one inside is like a like this type of like offset design. So because the The flathead screw, it is like, let me give a better angle. You can see the flathead screw, the design, see that? It's like a jar, okay, like this. Okay, that's why you have to use the wrong one, and then you can make it the this part of the point like this. So in this case, this one can fit into it. And but look at the regular screw. It is like a, it's like very evenly, like right here, it's completely flat. That's why you have to use this round one right here to make it to fit this type of screw head. Okay, what you're gonna do it is you're gonna using the Dremel. Give a better angle, you can see. Just make sure slowly, because you don't wanna break it. Because make sure it don't go all the way, otherwise this gonna be damaged, okay? So you're gonna make the little bit design like this. Let me give you a better angle, you can see. Okay, so in this case, this screw can almost hide into it. Let me give a better angle, you can see. See like this. Okay, so you can keep going slowly until it is about 95% into the carbon fiber. Just make sure to do it little by little, okay, like this. So right now it's almost there, so you should stop, because there's no way you can hide the Tamiya screw like this one right here to 100% hiding to the carbon fiber. There's no way. But I'm gonna give you another trick, which is can hide into it like 100%. Okay, so what you're gonna do next it is you're gonna put on the chassis first and set up. Okay, so you can see this still a little bit stick out, but it's okay. You can using the polish head, which is this one right here, remember? And using this one to shave off a little bit of screw head. Okay, what I mean it is, we're gonna take the regular screw. Okay, and using this polish head. To shave off a little bit, so it's gonna be looks like this. Let me give a better angle. You can see. Okay. Then let me put it back. You can see the result. Okay, so you can see, it's already compared with this one. I still have a little bit stick out right here. This one already gone. Okay. So next, when you put on setting board, check again. You won't see anything stick out. Okay, like this. Okay. So it's gonna be looks like this. So again, everybody had different type of design, especially the wheel size. Okay. So you can using a aluminum spacer or either washer to adjust the height of the these little pieces right here. Okay, so make sure it's not blocking the roller, not blocking the wheel. This one have to be always the lowest point of the chassis, and it's highly recommend these pieces about 1.5 millimeter to 2 millimeter away from the ground. So again, this one right here, it is about 1.8, which right here you can see it's about 1.8 millimeter away from the ground, which is pretty good. Okay, so if you want to go lower, go ahead and go lower, but make sure you have 1 millimeter clearance, the regulation. So make sure this piece is not going too low, like lower than 1 millimeter. So just keep it safe, like between 1.5 to 2 millimeter. Okay, so next I'm gonna show you a video clip, like a to explain how this thing, why it's very important. Okay, here's our last race. I'm at Green Lane. And it's a good start. I'm leading in the first place right now. Okay, and the other racer is still very gap to gap.
Okay. And right here, I got a little bit of car slowed down and a little racer passed by me, so I'm on second right now. And right here, be careful. And he got a car, so I passed by him and I'm back to first. Okay. So you'll see I'm pulling away and getting faster and faster. And it's still on the first place. And this is the last corner. Oops, right here, I get a flip over. So, okay, here's the two car design. And on the left is the guy who get a cut on the third lap. And on the right is my car. So you will notice my car on the right. You see there's two underguard which are located right here. And on the left, and his car actually don't have nothing right here. Okay, so when on the third lap, when his car jumps, this part right here and this part right here, so you will see the little screw head right here and the screw head right here. This is the part to get a cut. So when you get a cut on a screw head, it's really hard to get a shake off. And if you're lucky, you'll get a shake off, but you're gonna lose a lot of speed. So if you have the underguard setting like the two yellow pieces I'm circle right now, which is I have, like the second lap, I got a cut, and it's gonna be very fast to recover it. Because when you have underguard, it is these two yellow circle which I have right now, it is gonna be some kind of like sliding pieces which is can, you know, slides off on the side of the truck. So this is how you preventing your car getting caught. Because every single time your car jump the land, suppose you're gonna jump like 100 times, for sure there's a couple times you'll get a caught on the side of the truck. So that's why we have to have a piece of underguard on the bottom of the roller to preventing that situation happen. And in this case, you won't losing too many speed, and you're gonna, even you get a car, you're gonna have very fast recovery. You still can keep going on, okay? So unlike the car on the left, which is do not have underguard, when he get a car, it's really gonna slow you down a lot, okay?
Okay, let's come back to the real experiment. This is my car, which is get a car on the second lap. You can see I have underguard design right here. So every single time when I jump, there's a couple chances maybe I got a car on the side of the truck like this. Due to I have underguard which is located right here, even I got a car, I still gonna slide off. So it's giving very fast recovery, but for sure I'm gonna lose a little bit speed. But because of that, I'm not gonna losing too many speed, okay? So this is the car which is on the third lap, which don't have underguard, which is I using this car as a sample. So remember his car, there's no any underguard on the bottom, so all he have the screw head stick out. So when his car drop and land, it's gonna cut. So this screw head is gonna be very dangerous, because right here gonna cut. It's really hard to shake off. See that? So that's what happened to his car. He's gonna get a cut. It's still like a, you know, because his car's still moving, so you still have a chance to get shaked off. But in this case, you're gonna lose a lot of speed because it's really hard to get a slide off. So even you come back to the track again, you're gonna lose a lot of speed. Okay. So let's see the slow motion again. See how many speed he lose due to he don't have the underguard.
So here's slow motion. So you see side by side, he a little bit ahead of me. We jump on the same time. Right here, he got a car. You can see slow down a lot. That's why I come back to the first place. And this will tell you the underguard is really important when you get a car.